The 2nd and 3rd centuries were blessed with a number of Christian theologians who shaped the expression of the early church's faith. We will explore three figures in this episode, namely Ignatius of Antioch, Justin the Martyr, and Origen of Alexandria. Let's begin with Ignatius of Antioch. Ignatius of Antioch was born around 50 AD in Roman Syria and was martyred around the year of 110 AD in Rome as he was devoured by beasts in a Roman arena. His remains, or his relics, are now buried in St. Peter's Basilica. Not a lot of details about his life are known, and virtually all we know about him comes from the 7 letters he composed on his way to be executed in Rome. He was known for his opposition to Judaizers, who taught that it was necessary to adopt the Jewish customs and practices in order to become a Christian. He also opposed Docetists, a branch of Gnosticism. Scholars speculate that he might have known the Apostle John. Some of the main themes that appear in his writings include the double identity of Christ as God and man, martyrdom as unity with Christ, and the unity of the church gathered around one bishop and one Eucharist. Justin the Martyr was born around the year of 100 AD in Flavia, Palestine, and was martyred in 165 AD in Rome. After a long journey of exploring philosophy, Justin came to find the fullness of truth around the year 130 AD. He continued to appreciate the elements of truth in philosophy, as he continued to wear the philosopher's cloak even after his conversion. He wrote 2 apologies or statements in the defense of Christianity to Roman rulers of his time. In these 2 apologies, he juxtaposed Christianity with paganism and other philosophies, showing the former to be superior. Justin recorded in these apologies a coherent summary of Christian theology and life. For example, Justin summarizes the events of the liturgy in the following quote: "On the day called Sunday, there is a gathering together in the same place of all who live in a given city or rural district. The memoirs of the apostles or the writings of the prophets are read as long as time permits. Then when the reader ceases, the president in a discourse admonishes and urges the imitation of these good things. Next, we all rise together and send up prayers. When we cease from our prayer, bread is presented and wine and water. The president in the same manner sends up prayers and thanksgivings according to his ability, and the people sing out their assent, saying the Amen. A distribution and participation of the elements, for which thanks have been given, is made to each person, and to those who are not present, they are sent by the deacons. Those who have means and are willing, each according to his own choice, gives what he wills, and what is collected is deposited with the president. He provides for the orphans and widows, those who are in need on account of sickness or some other cause, those who are in bonds, strangers who are sojourning, and in a word, he becomes the protector of all who are in need." Justin was convinced that philosophies of his time included elements of the truth, which he titled Seeds of the Logos. The fullness of the Logos, however, is only found in Christ as confessed in Christianity. As Justin's voice of preaching kept getting louder, he was arrested for treason and was killed as he said, "If we are punished for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ, we hope to be saved." Origen was born in 184 AD in Alexandria, and died after he was arrested and tortured in 253 AD in Tyre in Lebanon. Origen acted as a presider or dean of the school of Alexandria. Due to arguments between Origen and the Patriarch of Alexandria, Demetrius, Origen chose to leave Alexandria and was ordained a priest in Lebanon. Some believe that the arguments between Origen and Demetrius were theological, while the majority of scholars believe that they were the result of Demetrius' concern with Origen's popularity, compromising his own authority as Patriarch of Alexandria. Though Origen died in communion with the Church, he was anathematized, or his teachings were renounced, in the Council of Constantinople II in the year 553 AD. Origen died having left the Church with a legacy of writings that reach approximately 6,000 works, including On First Principles, hundreds of commentaries on Scripture, and the Hexapla, which is a document where Origen compared different translations and versions of the biblical verses of the Old Testament. Years after his death, Basil of Caesarea and Gregory of Nazianzus relied on Origen in learning the Christian philosophy and theology. They compiled his spiritual sayings on prayer in what came to be known as the Philokalia of Origen of Alexandria.